They call her the Cat Lady. People call her crazy just because she has a few dozen cats. That was how Lisa Simpson described Dr. Eleanor Abernathy, also known as the Crazy Cat Lady, on the television show The Simpsons. She's a 40-something woman with so many cats that she frequently throws them at strangers when she's upset. Although this is a cartoonish exaggeration of the cat person archetype, there might be an ounce of truth in The Simpsons' exaggerated portrayal of the Crazy Cat Lady. That ounce of truth might just be the result of a single-celled parasite. Meet Toxoplasma gondii. Also called Toxo for short, this unicellular parasite causes the disease toxoplasmosis. The disease in itself isn't fatal. In fact, most people don't even know they have it. The symptoms, if they even show up, are like a mild flu, with swollen lymph glands and muscle pain as common symptoms. However, this isn't the craziest part about the disease. Toxo, some research suggests, can actually affect the behavior of its host. It seems that Toxoplasma gondii makes its hosts uninhibited risk-takers. In 2002, a study led by Jaroslav Fleger found that those infected with Toxo got into more car accidents than uninfected people. The researchers hypothesized that the parasite is responsible for such irresponsible and risky behavior. But how can a microscopic, single-celled parasite change the way we behave? Toxo can only sexually reproduce in the intestines of cats, but the baby toxo inside the cat's intestines, also called oocysts, cannot mature into adults there. To mature, they need a new environment, more specifically, the tissue cells of other mammals. Thus, the oocysts are excreted with the cat's feces, released into the real world to find their new home. This maturation host, the second host, is called the intermediate host, while the cat in which the parasite reproduces is called the primary host. Out there in the open environment, they wait. These oocysts are hardy and can survive for up to a year in a dormant state. The intermediate host comes in contact with these baby toxo by eating something with oocysts in or on it. Once within the host, the little baby toxo mature inside the tissue cells like the muscle cells and the CNS, the central nervous system of the animal. To complete the toxo's life cycle, the intermediate host is preyed upon and eaten by a cat. However, there's a slight hitch in this parasitic plan. Rats and most other animals are hardwired to avoid life-threatening danger, such as getting eaten by a predator. Toxo has a simple and effective solution for this. It simply changes the brain's wiring so the rat isn't as afraid. Scientists have been perplexed by the ingenious behavioral puppetry that Toxo performs for its own benefit. A rat under this effect seems to react slower to danger and isn't as scared of cats or other new things as it was pre-toxoplasmosis. It also develops a strange attraction or decreased dislike for cat urine and feces, and the parasite may even affect their memory and learning. This insidious strategy is genius. The only trouble, Toxo isn't too finicky about who it infects. It infects just about any warm-blooded animal unfortunate enough to have consumed it, either through contaminated water, dirt, or particularly in the case of humans, through eating meat infected with Toxo. The risky behavior identified in the 2002 study suggests that humans might be similarly affected by Toxo. Since humans are in no danger of being preyed upon by cats, our behavior just ends up being riskier. The parasite has enzymes that can synthesize the neurotransmitter dopamine, and some scientists are hypothesizing that this is one way Toxo hijacks the brain. However, in humans, this excess dopamine could also be the cause of certain psychiatric disorders, such as schizophrenia. About 30 to 60% of the world might be infected with this parasite. With so many people infected, we're still in the dark as to what sort of impact, if any, the parasite has on the human mind. We don't even know if Toxo affects the brains of cats, let alone the details of how it affects the brains of humans. However, we do know that we'll always be there to give those cats boxes to live in and laptop screens to scratch. We'll gladly clean up after them when they're done feeding themselves, because we simply can't help loving those little furballs.